Hello students, today let us continue the chapter 3 structure of matter. I hope you understood the topics explained in the last class. Let's revise what are they. We learned about elements, compounds, atom and molecule. And you already learned about the symbols. We use symbols to represent elements and we use formula to represent compounds. In today's class we are going to learn about some new terms. First one, atomicity. Atomicity is the number of atoms present in a molecule of an element. It means atomicity, how many atoms are there in a molecule, the number of atoms present in a molecule is called atomicity. The atoms of some elements exist independently. They are known as monoatomic elements. Mono means one. If there are only one atom, those type of elements are called monoatomic elements. Examples are helium, He is the symbol, only one atom, it exists as one atom. Neon, Ne is the symbol, both have the atomicity 1. Second type, the atoms of some elements do not exist independently. They form molecules containing two atoms. They are known as diatomic elements. Di means two. If there are two atoms in a molecule, they do not exist independently. They combine and form molecule having two atoms. Those type of elements are called diatomic elements. Examples, hydrogen H2, oxygen O2, nitrogen N2, chlorine Cl2. All these are examples of diatomic elements. Their atomicity is 2. And some atoms form molecules having more than 2 atoms. They are known as polyatomic elements. Some elements form more than 2 atoms. Molecules are formed from more than 2 atoms. Those type of elements are called polyatomic elements. Examples are phosphorus, symbol P4 molecule. P4 represents one molecule of phosphorus. Sulfur, S8. Phosphorus has the atomicity 4 and sulfur has the atomicity 8. Diatomic molecules, atomicity 2. And monoatomic molecules, atomicity 1. Now, let's go to the next topic. Next term, valency. Valency of an element or a group denotes its combining capacity. It denotes the combining capacity. We take valency of hydrogen as 1. The valency of other elements or groups is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine with or be displaced by one atom of that element or group. That means how many hydrogen atoms you can combine. The element can combine with how many hydrogen atoms. That number is called valency in terms of hydrogen. Helium, neon, krypton, etc. do not combine at all, so their valencies are 0. Helium, neon and krypton valency 0. Let's take an example, hydrochloric acid. In hydrochloric acid, one atom of chlorine combined with one atom of hydrogen. Therefore, valency of chlorine is 1 because it combines with one atom of hydrogen. So, the valency of chlorine is 1. In H2O, one atom of oxygen combines with two atoms of hydrogen. You can see one atom of oxygen combined with two atoms of hydrogen. So, valency of oxygen is 2 and valency of hydrogen is already 1. And let's take another example, zinc oxide. In zinc oxide, there is no hydrogen. So, we can find out the valency of zinc by using the valency of oxygen. One atom of zinc combines with one atom of oxygen. Both are equal. One atom of zinc combined with one atom of oxygen. We already know that the valency of oxygen is 2. Therefore, the valency of zinc is also 2. So, we can find out the valencies of different elements by using this technique, valencies. All the valencies are given in the note table, in a table. You can go through them, different valencies. Some elements have more than one valency. Sometimes this also happens. Some elements have more than one valency, so they are called they show variable valency. Now let's move to the next topic, writing formula. We can write the formula of a compound if we know the symbols of the elements or groups and the valencies of the elements or groups. We need two things to write the formula of a compound. First we need the symbols of the elements or groups and the valencies of the elements or groups. There are different steps. Steps involved in writing formula are: first step, write symbols of the elements or groups. First of all, we should write the symbols of elements and groups side by side. Write their valencies on top as superscripts of their symbols. Write the valencies on the top of the number, name, symbols. Now divide by any common factor in their valencies. Next step is divide. If there is any common factor, divide the valencies by that common factor. Now the last step, interchange the number obtained and write them at the base as subscripts. Before we wrote it as superscripts, now change them into subscripts to get the formula. Let's see an example, you can understand better. Write formula for ammonia. Example, write formula for ammonia. Elements present in ammonia are nitrogen and hydrogen. There are two elements, nitrogen and hydrogen. We can write nitrogen N for nitrogen, H for hydrogen. Then write the valencies on the top as superscripts. 3 N, valency of nitrogen is 3, valency of hydrogen is 1. N 3 H 1. On the top we can write the numbers 3 1. Now 3 and 1. The numbers valencies are 3 and 1. There is no common factor, so we can interchange the number directly. 3 comes here and the 1 comes here. So N 1 H 3. The formula changes to N1H3, or we can write it as NH3. So this is the formula of ammonia. Formula for ammonia is NH3. Now let's take another example, aluminium sulfate. Another example, aluminium sulfate. It is made up of aluminium Al and sulfate SO4. We already know, we can find out the valency from the table. Valency of aluminium is 3. Valency of sulfate, it is a group. We can write the valency of this group together is 2. Then we can write the symbols side by side. Now write the valencies. Al, aluminium valency is 3, sulfate valency is 2. There is no common factor, 3 and 2, valencies are 3 and 2, there is no common factor, so we can change it, interchange it like this. So the formula we obtained is, we get the formula as SO4Al2SO43. This is the formula of aluminium sulfate. The bracket is used because to show the whole sulfate group. Now another example, let's take another example, calcium carbonate. The formula, write the formula of calcium carbonate. It is made up of calcium, Ca is the symbol, and carbonate, CO3. This is a group. Ca, valency of calcium is 2, valency of carbonate is 2. CaCO3. Now this is 2, valency of carbonate 2. Now there is common, both the numbers are same, we can divide by 2. Divide by 2. We can get it as Ca1CO3 1. This is also can be written as CaCO3. So this is the formula of calcium carbonate. Let's take another example, H2O. This is water. hydrogen valency 1, oxygen valency 2. So we can write HO, hydrogen valency 1, oxygen valency 2. Then these are interchanged like this. So the formula for water is H2O. In this way, we can write the formulas of all the compounds if we know the valency and the symbol. The valencies of different elements or groups are given in the note. Now, let's move to the next topic, chemical equations. What are the chemical equations? What are chemical equations? A chemical equation shows the result of a chemical reaction in which the reactants and the products are represented by symbols or formula. If there is a chemical reaction, we can represent it in the form of formulas and symbols. By using formulas and symbols, we can represent the chemical reaction. That equation. To show that chemical reaction, we can write the equation. Now, what are reactants? The elements or compounds that take part in a chemical change. The elements or compounds that take part in a chemical change. There are some elements and compounds take part in a chemical change. Those are called reactants. Then products. The rearrangement of the elements from form new compounds in the reaction. These are called products. After the reaction, the result out of products. After the reaction, new compounds formed are called products. Rearrangement of elements form new compounds in the reaction. These are called products. Now, let's take an example. Iron reacts with sulfur to form iron sulfate. Iron reacts with sulfur to form iron sulfate. Let's write the equation. Symbol for iron. Iron, Fe, react with sulfur, S is the symbol, gives, this arrow we can read it as gives, FeS, that means iron sulfide. So reactants in this equation, chemical equation are, this is a chemical equation, this whole part is a chemical equation, then iron and sulfur are reactants, iron sulfide is the product. So we can understand reactant, these two are reactants and the final product is, this is product. In this way we can represent the chemical equation. Now there is an important requirement for writing an equation is that the number of atoms of each element on the left hand side should be the same as the number of atoms on the right hand side. It means equal number of atoms should be the each element. Fe, iron, one atom. Left hand side one atom of iron and right hand side also you can see one atom of iron, one atom of sulfur, one atom of sulfur. They both should be equal on the number of atoms should be equal on both sides. Now let's see the formation of breakdown of water. Another example, chemical equation you can see here, H2O break down to hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen and oxygen. So we already know that atomicity of hydrogen and oxygen is C2. So they do not exist independently. They form molecule. After they break down, they form molecule. Two atoms of hydrogen, two atoms of oxygen. H2O. This side, two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen. Number of atoms. Let us compare. Hydrogen number of atoms 2. In this side hydrogen, number of hydrogen 2. This side oxygen, number of oxygen 1. 1 oxygen atom. But this side, on the next side, we can see oxygen, number of oxygen 2. So there is a difference. In this side 1 oxygen and this side 2 oxygen. So we should balance them. In such cases we should balance the equation. We can balance the equation by putting there is difference here, so we cannot put a number here, we cannot change this number, we can change the number here, we can write 2 here. This means 2 H2O, two molecules of water. That means 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atoms, 2 oxygen atoms. There are 4 hydrogen atoms and 2 oxygen atoms. This side also, here, if here it is 4 hydrogen atom, we need 4 hydrogen atom also here also. So we can put 2 here, 2 into 2, 4 hydrogen atom plus 2 oxygen atom. So this is a balanced equation. The first equation was unbalanced. This is balanced equation. So equal number, hydrogen atom 2 into 2, 4, H, 4, O, 2, this side H, 4, oxygen 2. Now this equation is balanced. In this way, another equation, let's see, another example, let's see. Nitrogen reacts with hydrogen to give ammonia. N plus H. Nitrogen diatomic molecule, we should write N2. We can write N. We can't write N. We should write N2. H2 gives the ammonia formula already you know. NH3. Is this balanced? This equation is unbalanced. Because N number of nitrogen, this side 2, number of hydrogen 2, but here N is equal to N number of nitrogen 1, number of hydrogen 3. So there is a difference in numbers, so we should balance them. How can we balance them? N2, N1, nitrogen atom. First we should equalize the number of nitrogen atom. Here we should put, here 2 nitrogen atom, so here we should put 2. 2N, H3, 2 molecules of ammonia. Then 2 nitrogen, now can we can see nitrogen atom 2, hydrogen atom 2. Here 2 nitrogen atom, but we can multiply this 2 into 3. 6 hydrogen atom. So we should balance here also. Now this equation is balanced. 2 nitrogen atom plus 3 hydrogen. 3 into 2, 4, sorry, 6 hydrogen atoms gives 2NH3. Now N, this side N is equal to 2, H is equal to 6. The other side N is equal to 2, H is equal to 6. Now this equation is balanced. Okay. I hope you understood how to write the equation and how to balance them. This is balancing. Okay. I have given lot of exercises in notes also. You can try them and find out the balanced and unbalanced equation. More examples are given in the note. You can go through them and find out, learn how to write a formula and how to balance a chemical equation. I hope you have all understood the topics. Let's go to the summary part. The chapter, in this chapter, what we already learned. Summary. There are lot of points are given here. Already you learned in this chapter. First, an atom is the smallest particle of an element that can take place in a chemical equation. Second, a molecule is the smallest particle of an element or a compound that can normally exist independently. A compound always contains the same elements chemically combined together in a fixed ratio. In a mixture, the original atoms or molecules of the constituents remain unchanged and no new molecules are formed. In a mixture, the constituents can be represented in any ratio. Symbols are used to represent elements. The atomicity of element is the number of atoms present in one molecule of the element. The valency of an elemental group denotes its combining capacity. It is the number of hydrogen atoms which can combine with or displace by one atom of that element or group. Next point. We can write formula of a compound if the valencies of its constituent elements or groups are known. A chemical equation shows the result of a chemical reaction in which The reactants and the products are represented by the symbols or formula. And the last point is, an equation must be balanced, that is, the number of atoms of each element should be the same on both sides of the equation. So that's all. Here the chapter over. Let's see in the next class.